Welcome to ESD School, brought to you by Attract. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss a single episode. Enjoy the video.
So, dear all, today we will discuss about one of the most important background you should have before beginning ESD. It means knowing how to characterize a lesion in order to decide if this lesion should be removed by conventional resection like piecemeal MR, should it be removed by ESD, or should it be referred to surgery. We will discuss here only about colorectal neoplasia, and we will therefore try to cover the unavoidable background about advanced diagnosis for colorectal neoplasia. So first, we will discuss about why characterization is unavoidable, present you the CONNECT classification, try to explain the three steps characterization, which is the conventional mode of characterizing the lesions, some examples in order to achieve the session. So first, we should know that the endoscopist mission, which is the most important for the society, at least in the West, where colorectal neoplasia are the most frequent, is to be able to have major skills in detection, and therefore a high detection level, because as soon as the lesion is detected, she will be removed by any means. And therefore, it is very important to avoid missed adenocarcinoma or missed neoplasia. And once the lesion is detected, after we should have a high level of colorectal neoplasia management. It means being able to predict the histology, its characterization, being able to choose the good resection strategy, and having the good therapeutic skills adapted to your practice. It means if you remove only the lesion under 20 millimeter, you should be very good knowing cold snaring, for example. If you treat lesion between 20 and 35 millimeters, you should know all the new techniques to be very good in underwater EMR, like in R0 EMR, like anchoring EMR, tipping EMR, or underwater EMR. And if you are the expert of the region, you should be able to treat by ESD most of the lesion using an R0 new type of resection. After, we should know that, in fact, every cancer should be removed at least en bloc and, if possible, R0, because it's the only way to have a good histology assessment of the lesion. With ESD, you will have one cut of 6 to 8 microns every 2 millimeter. It means 0.4% of the lesion which is explored in volume. With surgery, only one cut every 5 millimeters, so finally only 0.2% of the lesion which is explored. And if you use piecemeal, it's a nightmare for pathologists to be sure of the depth of invasion and to be sure there is no missed budding, missed lymphovascular invasion, missed undifferentiated type component. So finally, what we should have in mind is that for a cancer, having a R0 resection is better in order to avoid the missed information that could lead to an adjuvant treatment for the patient. And finally, the lesion in the colon are very difficult to characterize because it's not white or black. There is a lot of gray in between the adenomas, the superficial adenocarcinoma, it means intramucosal carcinoma, for example, the shallow T1 cancer, the borderline cancer, which are the T1 deep invaded cancer, more than 1,000 micron, and the high-risk cancers, it means T2, T3, or T1 with pejorative factors like lymphovascular invasion, budding, or undifferentiated component. So finally, what should know the endoscopist is how to divide these different lesions, which are in fact a continuum of gray, trying to put them in some steps in which the most effective treatment could be Abstention, for example, for hyperplastic polyps, the best is probably to do nothing if you recognize the lesion. For all the lesions which are with no risk of T1 cancer, you should use snaring and cold snaring for lesion under 10 millimeter, en bloc snaring for the lesion between 10 and 25 millimeter using underwater EMR or TPIN EMR, for example. Piecemeal resection should be only reserved to the lesion with a very, very low risk of T1 cancer. It means mostly the lesion with a SSAP appearance or the granular homogeneous LSTs, where the risk of T1 cancer is inferior to 1%. But for all the other lesions, where the risk of T1 cancer is not null, we should probably go to R0 en bloc resection, like ESD or intermuscular dissection in the rectum, for example. And if your characterization leads to a lesion with a very high risk of T2 or more cancers, the best option is probably the extension checkup and the colectomy with lymph node dissection. But the morbidity is very high compared to endoscopy, and therefore we should keep surgery for the lesion that really benefit from surgery. It means T2 and more, or T1B with pejorative factors and more. So finally, our work will be to try to predict the histology in order to choose the best therapeutic. And for this, we have a lot of classification which have been provided in the time: Paris, Kudo, Sano, NICE, WASP. The GNET classification is trying to mix Kudos, Sanos, and NICE criteria, but does not consider the Paris aspect. And the CONNECT classification we have developed now 5 years ago or 6 years ago is trying to associate all the factors coming from Paris, Kudos, Sano, NICE, and WASP in order to cover all the histology we can find in the colon. So, second point, the CONNECT classification, which was published now in 2018 for the first study, which was only a pedagogic tool for French endoscopists. It was not an aim of creating a new classification, but just to try to combine all the published criteria in only one table in order to facilitate the work of the French endoscopists who got lost in this six classification: GNET, Sano, Kudos, NICE, WASP, and Paris. So finally, we came with this table with the histology predicted in the upper line, the macroscopic aspect, which is the Paris classification, the color coming from the NICE classification, the vessels coming from Sano's or GNET classification, the pits from Kudos or GNET, and the proposition of treatment for each kind of lesion. And we will see all these different parts. First, the hyperplastic polyp. We will not lose time with this. A very clear two-way of Paris shape, small lesion under 5 millimeter, usually in the rectosigmoid, with lacy vessels that cross the lesion. And those lesions are not neoplastic and could be let in place without any resection in order to reduce the cost, the ecological burden, and the pathology examination of this kind of lesion. Second point, the SSAP lesion coming from the WASP classification, with this mucus on the lesion, this cloudy aspect, indistinct borders, indistinct margins. Usually when you wash, you can see clearly the pattern, which is usually close to hyperplastic polyps, with lacy vessels crossing the lesions, sometimes type 2O pit pattern with a star shape pattern of pits, but with a black dot at the middle of the crypt, which is quite characteristic of the SSAP. Sometimes these SSAP are dysplastic and have both two components, one which is very typical of SSAP and one which seems to adenoma, usually more like a non-granular LST in one part and SSAP in the other part. And these lesions are a combination of adenoma and SSAP on your characterization and are usually the dysplastic SSAP. After we have the low risk adenoma, it means the adenoma with less than 1% of T1 cancers. It is the lesion with a size inferior to 10 millimeters, even if they have the Valley sign, this 0 to C of Paris aspect. And all the lesions that have this aspect of adenoma with very regular pits and vessels around the pits, it means SANO 2 or CUDO 3L4. But when the lesion is reaching 10 millimeter and is a laterally spreading tumor, the only lesion which have a very low risk of T1 cancer in these conventional adenomas are the homogeneous type granular LSTs without macronodule, without a nodule over 1 centimeter. These lesions are the lesion with a low risk of T1 cancer that can be treated by piecemeal EMR without a risk of missing a T1 cancer. So we will see the different resection we can provide for the lesion with a very low risk of T1 cancer. First, the cold snaring, which is really the gold standard for the lesion under 10 millimeter, and which could become also a standard for larger lesion with piecemeal cold snaring, but probably we need more data to know exactly which kind of lesion is suitable for this strategy. So this is cold snaring, a very high quality resection with usually margin around the lesion and very low risk. So it is the combination of a high quality resection profile and a high safety profile. So in fact, it is the best option for the lesion under 10 millimeter. Next, probably the two new types of EMR that can improve your en bloc and R0 resection rate for the lesion in between 10 and 25 millimeter. First, the T-pin EMR. You do a small dot in the submucosa with the tip of the snare. It fixes the tip of the snare, making able the deformation of the snare. And therefore, you can oblige the snare to get a round shape. We are a little far, but we will come back to see really the margin of the lesion. We have large margin and R0 resection, which is improved compared to conventional EMR, and then can help to have more R0 resection. The second new strategy to improve your R0 resection rate is the underwater EMR. Even for a relatively small lesion like this one, under air, you inflate the colon and increase the size of the lesion artificially. And therefore, using underwater will make the lesion floating, reducing in size, and you are able to catch it in only one piece with margin while using only a small snare, thanks to the power of water. So this is the second way to improve your R0 resection rate by doing conventional EMR. And the last technique, which is probably still the reference in the world for the lesion between above 25 millimeter with no risk of cancer. It means a granular LST homogeneous type. It's a resection from 2015 from Professor Ponchon. We try to do the minimum number of pieces being safe, so we don't want to take very large pieces, but we try to reduce the number, which could reduce also the number of recurrences. And after the resection, it is now recommended to do a thermal ablation of the margin. And whatever the technique of thermal ablation used, the risk of recurrence is low but not null, and therefore the early follow-up is recommended at 6 months after a piecemeal EMR, even if you did the thermal ablation. So next step, the three steps characterization. And now we will focus ourselves on the lesion with a risk of malignancy. It means the adenoma with a high risk of T1 cancer, the borderline adenocarcinoma, and the deeply invasive adenocarcinoma, connect 2C, 2C+, and 3. So what we should know is that the characterization is a three-step process. First, you can get information coming from the whole aspect of the lesion by using the Paris classification with a far view in white light of the lesion. And it will help you to know the macroscopic shape and sometimes the color of the lesion compared to the background. So first, it is a statistical risk of carcinoma, overt or covert, but using only the macroscopic shape of the lesion by a white light far view of the whole lesion, you will be able to precise the risk of T1 cancer inferior to 1% in the granular homogeneous type LSTs, 8% with a nodule which is different from the lesion under 1 cm, and 18% if it's over 1 cm. 87% of T1 cancer if there is a depressed demarcated area in a granular LST, 27% if it's a surelevated non-granular LST, and 47% if it's a pseudo-depressed type of non-granular LSTs, 90% if there is a nodule in the pseudo-depressed area. Some example, first, the homogeneous type granular LST with no nodules over 1 cm, which is probably the only very good candidate for piecemeal EMR. Because in this kind of lesion, the risk of cancer is probably under 1 cm. So we will try to use retroflexion to show you the lesion, which was just above the valvula. In the right colon, a little masked by the fold, but relatively large, and we tried to cover all the area of the lesion slowly to be sure there was no demarcated area and that we had only small granules, relatively homogeneous, all the same type, no large nodule, and no demarcated area of irregular or amorphous pattern. An example of this type of granular homogeneous type LSTs with another scope brand, which is the same. Many small nodules, no one which is bigger than the other, no irregular area, no demarcated area, no red sign, nothing. And therefore, this is the good example of low risk T1 cancer. Now, a connect 2C lesion, which is the lesion with a risk of T1 adenocarcinoma, the non-granular type surelevated LSTs. So you can see that there is no pseudo-depressed area, only a flat lesion with a quite regular pattern, but no granules, only a flat surelevated plate. Relatively difficult to detect, and when you go close, the vessel seems regular, no area without pattern, no area with irregular pattern, and this lesion have a risk around 20% of T1 cancer, despite the fact that you see nothing in your characterization, and for us, this kind of lesion are good candidate for ESD. The next aspect is the pseudo-depressed non-granular LSTs, where the risk is 47%. Here you have also the chicken skin aspect around the lesion. And this kind of lesion, despite the fact that there is no irregular or amorphous pattern in the lesion, is associated with a significant risk of T1 cancer, and for us should be treated only by ESD in order to get a R0 specimen and avoid cutting in pieces a T1 cancer with a loss of information. So second step of characterization is the fact that you should search the demarcated red area because usually the malignancy comes from only one area. It's very rare to have a completely malignant lesion. Usually it's a large adenoma with a focal malignancy, which is in this picture on the right under corner. When we injected, you see this nodule, which is very red. It's the red sign because you have more vessels in this area. And when we came very close to the lesion, the pattern was amorphous in a very small area. So we classified 5N of Kudo, SANO3B, but in an area of less than 1 centimeter. It is very important to know that it's difficult to find these T1 cancers, and to find them you should have a complete exploration of the lesion. It means in both direct viewing and retroflexion, because sometimes it's difficult to see within a lesion the area of malignancy. Another example of a red sign area, which should really be a red flag for you to focus your examination. It was a granular LST with a large nodule addressed for ESD with no malignancy detected. But once searching with the cap, you can see that in fact, in one small area under 12 millimeter, there was a T1 cancer located in this area with a very small area of destroyed pattern at the middle, less than 10 millimeter. So we did a diagnostic ESD in order to get a specimen and know if the patient could benefit from an endoscopic resection. But unfortunately, in this case, it was impossible to achieve the complete resection. We did a complete resection on block of the lesion, but in fact, there was a small infiltration of the muscle under the lesion that we had to cut. And finally, the resection was R1, and on the surgery specimen, there was a small T2 cancer remaining at this area. So the last part, when you have detected an area of interest with a demarcated area, a red sign or something like this, you should do a complete examination with chromoendoscopy and, if possible, with zoom of this area to determine if this area is something irregular with a remaining pattern, which is usually the lesion with a low risk of T1 cancer or very shallow T1 cancer. It's Kudo 5I or SANO3A, and it is in the classification connect to C. Or if you have an amorphous area with destruction of all the patterns and an avascular area with destruction of all the vessels, with only large vessels coming but not no organization. And finally, you will have this. If you have irregular pattern, remaining pattern irregular, you are more in the adenomas with high risk of T1 cancer or shallow T1 cancers. And if you have amorphous areas, avascular areas, SANO3B, Kudo 5N or GNET 3, if the area is very small, under 10 millimeter, ESD could be attempted as a diagnostic means to get a specimen and really select the patient who can be cured by endoscopy and the one that should be referred to surgery. If the area is over 10 millimeter, diagnostic ESD is frequently a failure. Most of the patient will have a deep invasive cancer, and probably for this lesion with an area of more than 10 millimeter, we should classify them in connect tree and therefore have an extension checkup and a surgery directly. And finally, you have the 2C plus lesion with a small area of invasive pattern, Kudo 5N or SANO3B, but less than 10 millimeter in size. Diagnostic ESD is our strategy. And for the lesion with an area of more than 10 millimeter, here extension checkup and surgery is the connect tree lesion. And finally, some examples. First, an example which is a little different from what we discuss, which is the yellowish submucosal tumors of the rectum, which can correspond to submucosal tumors like NETs, neuroendocrine tumors. For this lesion, we should have a good quality resection from the beginning, if possible, because if you are R0 and the lesion is G1, you can skip all the follow-up and consider the patient totally cured. If you have done a resection with forceps or cold snare or anything which is R1, you will have to follow the patient all his life, despite the fact that the lesion is probably at very low risk. So if you recognize this kind of lesion, you can do a small biopsy just to get the pathology report of NET, but after, schedule an advanced resection. It means CAP EMR, band ligation EMR, ESD, EFTR, what you want, but advanced. EMR, standard EMR is very bad for these NETs, and you should avoid this R1 resection by doing an advanced resection first. This is an example of neuroendocrine tumor in the rectum, which was not so much yellow, but more or less red with a yellow aspect at the middle, not a conventional aspect. You can see that it is a submucosal tumor, but with some abnormalities on the mucosal pattern, because as you know, NETs are not only submucosal tumor, they are mucosal tumor going into the submucosa. So sometimes you have also some abnormalities of the pattern in surface, and this kind of lesion should be referred for advanced resection and not by a conventional means, in order to get a R0 resection and have a precise histological assessment. Next case, an example, which is a non-granular LST, which for me is a non-granular LST which is surélevated. You can see that with the new scopes, with new NBI in this case and zoom, you have a very precise assessment of the crypt and the vascular pattern. But in this case, it was a non-granular LST, not depressed, surélevated, with no area of demarcated pattern. Everything, it was quite regular. So for me, SANO 2 and probably Kudo 4 or 3L, but no area of really irregular pattern. We did ESD because of the aspect of non-granular LST, but finally it was only high-grade dysplasia for this lesion.
La surexposition.
So we classified it as connect to
C. La nouvelle série
I'm sorry. Okay. Second example, a lesion which was connect to C plus because it was less than 10 millimeter, it enters the cap, but with a destroy pattern, I mean Kudo 5N or SANO 3B, but less than 10 millimeter in size. We did an ESD for diagnostic purpose, and in this case, it was a 3700 T1 cancer with an invasion of 3700 microns in the submucosa, well differentiated with budding, but no lymphovascular invasion, and the ESD was not curative. So finally, to summarize, characterization is totally unavoidable for endoscopists who want to perform ESD because we should predict histology, at least to predict the different lesions that will not benefit from ESD. It means the lesion with only benignant component and the lesion with deep invasive cancer over T2, connect 3. There are three different risks of T1 cancer. The connect 2A lesion, it means the granular LST with homogeneous type, which have less than 1% of T1 cancer. The 2C lesion, non-granular LSTs, granular LSTs with macronodule, demarcated area with irregular pattern, the risk is in between 10 and 50% of T1 cancer, and this lesion should be treated by ESD. and the connect2C plus, where an adenocarcinoma is clearly visible, borderline, that should be removed by ESD in order to get a specimen, see in pathology if the patient is cured or if he should be referred to surgery for a complementary salvage surgery. Characterization is a difficult science and training is needed. Artificial intelligence nowadays is not available for this kind of grayscale of the neoplastic lesion. The only thing that AI is able to do for the moment is to differentiate hyperplastic from the other lesion, but absolutely not to say to you it's an adenoma, it's a shallow cancer, it's a deep cancer. And the best way probably to be trained is to see a lot of lesions. And what we propose to French people for this is our Facebook page, HEH Endoscopy, in order to get a lot of pictures with the pathology report to be trained every day of seeing a lot of lesions. I hope it was nice for you, and I hope we will see soon in the next episode, probably about trimming. See you.
Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and share it with your colleagues. Until next time, this is ESD School via Tract.